Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Amen. Our Lady, health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
San Roque.
Pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many. As we gather to celebrate this Holy Mass, let us ask God's grace that we may seek glory, that we may seek greatness through humble and loving service. Let us offer this Mass for all those who are sick, especially our Archbishop Cardinal Jose Advincula. Let us pray for our frontliners and medical healthcare workers. Let us pray for those who are sick, and for the families they have left behind, for those who have died, and for the families that they have left behind. Let us now call to mind our sins and beg the forgiveness by which we are renewed and saved. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The wicked say, "Let us beset the just one, because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doings, reproaches us for transgressions of the law, and charges us with violations of our training. Let us see whether his words be true. Let us find out what will happen to him. For if the just one be the Son of God, God will defend him and deliver him from the hand of his foes. With revilement and torture, let us put the just one to the test, that we may have proof of his gentleness and try his patience. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to his own words, God will take care of him." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord upholds my life.
The Lord upholds my life.
O God, by your name save me, and by your might defend my cause. O God, hear my prayer, hearken to the words of my mouth.
The Lord upholds my life.
For the haughty have risen up against me, the ruthless seek my life. They say not God before their eyes.
The Lord upholds my life.
Behold, God is my helper. The Lord sustains my life. Freely will I offer you sacrifice. I will praise your name, O Lord, for its goodness.
The Lord upholds my life.
A reading from the letter of Saint James. Beloved, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder and every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure, then peaceable, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet but do not possess. You kill and envy but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask but do not receive, because you ask wrongly, to spend it on your passions. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My feet and a light on my path. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus and his disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee. But he did not wish anyone to know about it. He was teaching his disciples and telling them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill him. And 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise." But they did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to question him. They came to Capernaum, and once inside the house, he began to ask them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they remained silent. They had been discussing among themselves on the way who was the greatest. Then he sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be the last of all and the servant of all." Taking a child, he placed it in their midst, and putting his arms around it, he said to them, "Whoever receives one child such as these in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, who is the greatest? This is the question that the disciples of Jesus were arguing about as they were on a journey. Who is the greatest? Sino ba ang pinakadakila sa atin? Jesus intimated to his disciples what will happen to him in Jerusalem, that the Son of Man will be handed over to men and they will kill him, and 3 days later he will rise again. But it is surprising that after Jesus told them these things, the disciples were not even bothered. They were not even troubled about what will happen to Jesus. Biro nyo sinabi sa kanila ni Jesus, "Pahihirapan ako, papatayin ako, ngunit muli akong mabubuhay pagkatapos ng 3rd araw. Ni hindi man lamang sila nag-alala sa narinig nila. Hindi man lamang nila tinanong si Jesus, "Bakit ka ba nila papatayin? Sino ba ang papatay sa'yo? Ano ba ang pwede nating gawin para maiwasan yan?" They were not even bothered at all, because they were so preoccupied with greatness. Who is the greatest? That is why our gospel today tells us they did not understand what Jesus said because their focus was on greatness. They allowed their ambition to prevail. And so Jesus tried to shift their focus by saying, if one wants to be first, then he should be the last of all. If anyone wishes to be the greatest, then he should be the servant of all. Sino mang nagnanais na maging una, dapat maging huli. Sino mang nagnanais maging dakila, dapat maging lingkod ng lahat. My dear brothers and sisters, we all want to be great. We all want to be the first. We all want to be on top of everyone. We want to emerge as the best. Kaya nga, yung mga bata, sasabihin natin, mag-aral kang mabuti para ikaw ang number one sa klase nyo. Kaya sa trabaho, pinagsisikapan natin para mapunta tayo sa mataas na pwesto. We all want greatness for ourselves. And there is nothing wrong about it. Hindi masamang hangarin ang kadakilaan. Dahil nilikha tayo ng Diyos para maging dakila. We are destined for greatness. But we must always remember that we are called to the greatness not according to the standards of the world, but according to the standards of Jesus. For the world, greatness is about being served. For the world, greatness is having many people at your beck and call. Ang kadakilaan sa mundong ito ay yung ikaw ang pinaglilingkuran, ikaw ang pinapanginoon, isang salita mo lang nagtataranta na ang mga tao sa pagsunod sa iyo. But for Jesus, true greatness comes in service. You become great when you serve. Para kay Jesus, ang tunay na kadakilaan ay hindi yung ikaw ang pinaglilingkuran, kundi ikaw ang naglilingkod. For the world, greatness is being there on top, tinitingala ka ng lahat. But for Jesus, greatness is in humility, sa pagpapakumbaba, doon tayo nagiging dakila. For the world, greatness is about exalting oneself. But for Jesus, greatness is about thinking less of yourself and thinking more of others. Ang taong tunay na dakila, hindi inaangat ang kanyang sarili, kundi kinakalimutan pa nga ang kanyang sarili at inuuna ang kapwa, naglilingkod, nagmamahal ng may pagpapakumbaba. Yan ang tunay na kadakilaan sa batayan ng Diyos. At yan ang kadakilaang dapat nating hangarin. If there is any greatness that we should desire for ourselves, it is the greatness that comes from humble and loving service. Serve others, and you will be great in the eyes of God. My dear brothers and sisters, I am sure that you understand what we are talking about. We have always looked at people as great when they know how to truly serve others. Look at Mother Teresa of Calcutta. Remember what she did. She served the poorest of the poor. And by serving the poorest of the poor, the whole world looked upon her as great. Hindi naman niya inangat ang kanyang sarili. Naglingkod pa nga siya sa mga dukha at sa mga may sakit. And because of that loving service she extended to others, her greatness is revealed. Hinangaan siya ng buong mundo. And this happens in day-to-day life. Yung mga taong gumagawa ng mabuti para sa kapwa, yung mga taong naglilingkod ng tunay, sila ang tunay na dinadakila. Kapag may isang taong gumawa ng kabutihan para sa kanyang kapwa, hindi ba yung mga yan ang nagva-viral sa social media? Hinahangaan nating lahat. Kapag merong isang tao na nagbalik ng pera sa nakaiwan nito, hinahangaan natin ang kadakilaan ng taong yan. Hindi siya natukso na sarilinin at itago ang perang hindi naman kanya. Kapag merong isang kabataan na nagbigay ng kanyang upuan sa nakatatanda, hinahangaan natin dahil sa kanyang paglilingkod at kabutihang ginawa. Sa panahon natin ngayon, yung ating mga healthcare workers, hinahangaan natin, dinadakila natin, we even call them heroes because of their loving service. Kinakalimutan ng para sa sarili para maglingkod sa kanilang kapwa. Sa ating pagkakaunawa, ang tunay na kadakilaan nakikita natin sa mga taong tunay na naglilingkod. But those people who seek greatness only for themselves, we disdain them. Yung mga taong ang hanap lamang ay kadakilaan para sa sarili ko, itinataas ang sarili, inaangat ang sarili, yung mga taong yan, ang dadalhin niyan ay gulo, pagkakawatak-watak, at pagkakabahabahagi. And this is what we see in our first reading today. Evil people plotting against good people. And why are evil people so angry with good people? Because the evil people could not be great because of the presence of the good people. Galit na galit yung masasama sa mga mabubuti. Pinagtatangkaan nilang patayin ang mga mabubuti dahil, sabi ng masasamang tao, dahil sa mabubuting taong yan, hindi tayo maging dakila. Ipinamumukha kasi ng mabubuti ang kasamaang ginagawa nila. Dahil sa kabutihan ng mabubuting tao, lalong nahalata ang kasamaan ng masasamang tao. Dahil sa katotohanan na sinasabi ng mabubuting tao, lalong nahahalata ang kasinungalingan ng masasamang tao. Kaya galit na galit sila sa mabubuting tao. Ganyan naman talaga yata. Kaya tayo nagagalit doon sa gumagawa ng mabuti, matuwid, at nagsasalita ng totoo dahil napaghahalata tayo. Ang ating kasalanan, ang ating maling mga ginagawa, ang ating buktot na pamamaraan. And so, because good people hinder bad people from being great, then bad people wish to exterminate good people from the face of the earth. St. James, in our second reading today, also warns us, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder and every foul practice. Kung saan may selos at makasariling hangarin, nandyan ang kaguluhan at lahat ng uri ng kasamaan. Ang kaguluhan, inggit, selos, nagmumula sa paghahangad ng kadakilaang makasarili. My dear brothers and sisters, we all want to be great. And God wants each one of us to be great. But let us be great according to the example of Jesus. Sundan natin yung kadakilaang ni Jesus. Yung kadakilaang tinamo ni Jesus sa kanyang pag-aalay ng kanyang sarili para sa atin. If you want to be great, then serve others lovingly and with humility. If you want to be great, then seek the greatness not according to the standards of the world, but according to the standards of God. Let us seek greatness that is derived from humble and loving service, for that is the only greatness worth seeking. That is the only true greatness. That is the greatness that is pleasing to the eyes of God, and that is the kind of greatness that will surely lead us to heaven. Let us all together profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Christ our Lord predicted His saving death and resurrection. Through Him, the suffering servant, let us bring our petitions to the Father of all mercies. For every petition, let us say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Pope, who is the servant of the servants of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and harmony between those nations set against one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to jealousy and destructive competition among members of our families, Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for an end to the pandemic, that the sick be healed, especially our beloved Archbishop Jose, that those who care for them be strengthened, and help us all to persevere in faith and charity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the faithful departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for our personal petitions. We remember the people who requested our prayers. Let us also pray for the intentions offered in this Mass. Father of our Savior, these prayers we bring before you express our faith in your Son, who humbled himself to die on the cross for us and rose again to be our glorious Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to pray.
Sa tukso at iyan. Iadiamo po kami sa lahat ng masama.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat sa pakikisa sa ating banal na misa ngayong linggong ito mula dito sa Manila Cathedral. Maraming salamat din po sa iba't ibang mga social media platforms na nagbabahagi ng ating pagdiriwang ng banal na misa. We also thank our brothers and sisters, especially those from other countries who are joining this celebration. Thank you for being part of our community here at the Manila Cathedral. And may God bless this new week. May God always protect us, and may God teach us to seek greatness through humble service. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God of all consolation order your days in His peace, and grant you the gifts of His blessing now and forever.
Amen.
May He free you always from every distress, and confirm your hearts in His love now and forever.
Amen.
So that on your life's journey, you may be effective in good works, rich in the gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and may come happily to eternal life forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Panginoon, sa iyong punlad, isyong kaloob sa ating puso, aming sarili ay aming handog, laging tapat at laging tugon, naririto handa kami, Panginoon.